managerial accounting, costing systems. We're going to talk about job order costing. And first, we're going to compare and contrast the two different types of costing systems you will learn about this course in this semester. One is called job order costing. The other is called process costing. Both of them relate to how do we accumulate the costs to make a product or provide a service. So let's look at the differences in the types of products. Job order costing is made for custom orders. In other words, the customer tells you first what they want, tells you the specific features that they want in it, and then you make it to their order or to their specifications. So if I was making cookies and I asked my kids, hey, what kind of chocolate chip cookies do you want? They would tell me they want big cookies, they want chewy cookies, they want cookies with no nuts or with nuts, and I would make them to their specifications. So this would be a customized order. So here it's specific for a particular customer. Process costing, on the other hand, is where we're making identical products. In other words, one cookie looks exactly like the next one. I've always marveled at Oreo cookies, haven't you, as to how each and every one of them looks like exactly the same? Or if you were looking at chocolate chip cookies, this would be Chips Ahoy. Notice how Chips Ahoy cookies all look alike. Now, in between here, there is another mutation of this, and it's a hybrid. It's a little bit of job and a little bit of process. So for example, if I was doing Chips Ahoy cookies, are there different types of Chips Ahoy? Yes, and some of those different types of Chips Ahoy chewy with no nuts, are sold in a certain color package, whereas the original Chips Ahoy are a different type. So they're identical products in those packages, but notice they have some customized features for each product line in the brand. And that's why it's called a hybrid. It's between job and process. But in this class, we're going to say things are either job, custom, special order, or process, identical products. Now, when we look at this as far as the accounting for it, work in process, we know, is the factory or where we combine the ingredients to make the cookies. So in a job order cost system, we're going to have a work in process account for each job. So we can accumulate the cost for each job specifically and track it to that particular custom order. Whereas in process costing, we're going to have many work in process accounts, because how we'll keep them is by department. So if I was making cookies, I might have a work in process mixing department where I mix up the cookies. Then that dough would go from work in process mixing to work in process, I bet it's called baking. And then once the cookies are baked and out of the oven, it would go to a third work in process account, which would be called work in process packaging, where we would put those cookies in the packages, and then finally it would go to finished goods. So notice in process costing, many different work in process accounts, one for each department. Job order costing, a work in process account for each job. So if you work on 10 jobs, you could have 10 different work in process accounts. Now, as far as the documents that track these costs, in job order costing, we have something called a job order cost card. And there's many examples of a job order cost card in the book. And basically, that's where you take the customer's order, you track your materials, your labor, and your overhead costs, you accumulate your costs, you compare that to what the customer paid you for those, and you see if you got a profit or not on that job order. Versus under process costing, what we'll see in the process costing chapter is we're going to be doing a process cost report, which I also like to call the production report. And you've got to do this report in order to accumulate your costs so you know how much cost you should assign to ending work in process and to the goods or the products or services completed. So that's a little bit about comparing and contrasting job order versus process costing.